Right now, and let's go back to the other story that's developing at this hour, the private film that's been taken off an exhibition in Beijing. My colleague Nidhi Razdan now joins me for more. Nidhi, certainly a very drastic step for the Ministry of External Affairs to pull a film by a private filmmaker at a private exhibition just because the Indian ambassador was present. How are they justifying this action?
Well, basically, Maya, what happened is that this gallery has been traveling from country to country for some years now. It's a prestigious private art exhibition where some 200 Indian artists exhibit their work in the form of artwork, documentaries, short films, and so on. And Tejal Shah, who's a very well-known documentary filmmaker from Mumbai, had done this short film on Gujarat, talking about atrocities against Muslims in Gujarat. And about a month ago, this exhibition traveled to Beijing, where it was inaugurated by the Indian ambassador to China. Now, what the government here says privately is that it's extremely embarrassing to have a film that is screened at an exhibition like this, which the ambassador inaugurates, which is very, very critical of an Indian state, where you have people on the film apparently, you know, questioning Indian democracy, you know, very, very sharply criticizing Gujarat Chief Minister Narendra Modi. And therefore, since the ambassador did officially inaugurate the event, they see it as an embarrassment to India, particularly since it was screened in China. What MEA officials tell us is that for the last month or so, while this film was being screened at this exhibition, they had no idea about it. They didn't know when the ambassador inaugurated it. They didn't know over the last 4 weeks or so, until they started getting complaints from the local Indian community in China, which kept calling in and writing in
but
to the local embassy
Nidhi,
in Beijing.
As much of an embarrassment as it may be, it also indicates some level of censorship, which ideally should not be acceptable. And is it, as you said, because this film is being screened in China, it makes it even more problematic? Had it been screened in any other country, in any other part of the world, that even if it had come to the notice of the MEA, it may have not reacted the same way?
I think perhaps that could be right. I think there are additional sensitivities here because this was a screening taking place in Beijing, and the MEA, you know, clearly says that once they found out that this is what was happening, they immediately asked the organizers to pull the film from the exhibition, and they are saying that the organizers readily agreed. We've asked Tejal Shah, the filmmaker herself, for a comment and a reaction to what has happened. She is currently traveling out of the country, and we're hoping to hear from her via email very soon. But it is a controversial move for the government to step in like this in a private exhibition. The organizers seemingly, you know, seem to have agreed. But I think you're right that the sensitivities are far greater because it's China. We've had a strong BJP reaction on this story as well in the last hour or so, Maya, with the BJP spokesperson saying that the Indian ambassador should be called to explain why, you know, he inaugurated such an event. And the BJP, of course, has reacted very angrily because it's a short film on Gujarat that is at the center of this storm. So this is something that's bound to generate controversy in the days ahead as well.
Right. Nidhi, thanks very much for joining us with the latest. As you said, it is something which is bound to generate a certain amount of controversy as it does come into the public domain. The MEA stepping in to pull out a film on the Gujarat riots from a private exhibition in Beijing. Additional sensitivities perhaps at play, as Nidhi Razdan said.
India's number one news app just got even better. Download NDTV's new app, fully optimized for retina display, full screen view, faster response time, and Sudoku. NDTV's new iPad app. Download now.